Just in the Kitchen with me, your host, Justine. Today, I am going to make pita chips. Now, I've made them with za'atar, I've made them with sumac, I've made them with dill, but these are just gonna be plain. And I'll tell you how to do the others when I start doing these. Just gonna put them on the plate. I'm cutting them in half. Then I'll do it, depending, in a quarter. Can you see all of that? Quarter, and an eighth. And I just bought this whole thing of pita bread. And it will make more than you get in those, there's pita chips you can buy. And these are better and fresher. All you do is you cut them. I'll get one more on there because I'm going to do it in two batches. So I think there were, let me see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 of them. And it probably makes you about equivalent of 2 family size bags or whatever. And they're bigger. The reason I'm not putting any flavor on them is because when I use hummus, when I do hummus, I'll do za'atar or I will do sumac. But when I do the tzatziki that I just made, what I'll do is something like dill, thyme, something like that, that would go good with that. So I don't want to mix them. I'm going to let this be my vehicle for my dips. Then all you do is just put them out. Well, I could do one more. I'll do 4 and 4. How about that? Then I'm going to drizzle olive oil and I'm going to stir them up. And I'm going to put salt over them. I'm going to lay them out in a single layer so they'll bake nicely. Just fit them on here. It's like a puzzle. Yay! I will put them in a 350 degree oven and I will turn them halfway through. Turn them the pan and flip them over. Lone man, go in. There we go. Like I said, it's a puzzle getting them all on here. I'll put them in the oven, turn them around, and then I'll bring them out when they're done. And we'll taste them with my luscious tzatziki. Look at my chips. Look how wonderful. Listen how crispy. Mmm. And they're good all by themselves. If you want to add the extra sumac, any of that, do it. Do it, do it, do it. I want to be able to taste this. So, look at that. Look at that bite. Mmm. Great for summertime. Great for 4th of July. If you're going to do a wedding, what I would suggest, little cup, get one of these, set it right there with a little dill in the cup, and put a chip right there. So then people aren't tipping. You know, now everybody's very careful and they are wisely. So instead of having it all in one, put it in a little, like a little shooter, tzatziki shooter with a cucumber, a little bit of dill, and a chip right up on top. I'm gonna, my third dip will be dill dip. And I'm going to show you how to put it in a cup and make it pretty. I've done it for weddings. It'll be really easy, but this, you can't go wrong with this. And for a party for 4th of July, like I said, just get it in their own little servings. Give them, or like, you know those paper cups that hot dogs come in? Put a little bit of the chips in there, and give them a little cup of their own. Then they don't have to worry about dipping into anybody else's. So, for these recipes, for the pita chips, or the dill dip, or any of the other recipes that I'm making, just go to www.justinthekitchen.com and they'll be up there for you to get all the measurements. And remember, like, share, subscribe, please, on YouTube. I would really appreciate it. All right, this is my last video for today. I'll be doing some tomorrow and the next day, but I can feel my hair getting bigger and bigger because it gets hot in the kitchen. So it starts off nicely. I don't have a makeup team. I don't have a hair team. And it gets bigger by the end of it because I am sweating and I am hot. All right, thank you. Happy 4th of July. God bless.